Hey you guys, it's your girl Bree, and welcome back to my
channel.
Go ahead and click that subscribe button. And if you're not new to my channel, then welcome back, family. All right, you guys. So I know I'm like a day late on putting this video out, but truth be told, your girl had a whole bunch of stuff going on this week, and it's been a productive week, I'll say that. But here I am, better late than never, right? On this episode, we're actually going to be doing talking about something a little bit different. It'll be about relationships. So I don't know if I technically want to call this Freaky Friday, because it's not really going to be freaky, but we might, depending on where the topic goes, it might be freaky. I don't know, but we'll see. But for the most part, it'll just be like some regular relationship talk. If you would like to enter my giveaway, remember I have a giveaway going, and the last day to enter the giveaway is February 13th, so the day before Valentine's Day. On Valentine's Day, that is the day I will announce the winners. I might go live, I'm not sure yet, but I might do a quick little video or go live, and I'm going to announce the winners, and you'll see me picking out the names and everything. And then I'll also show you guys what you're actually winning, so, because I know you guys are like interested in that. All right, so to enter the giveaway, first you want to subscribe, and also if you happen to subscribe and you are the winner, I will check to make sure that you are subscribed to my channel. Okay, so make sure you subscribe, make sure you like this video, give it a big thumbs up, and comment, and then go follow me on Instagram and put your YouTube name under the giveaway photo. That way I will be able to reach out to you and tell you, you know, you're the winner. Now let's get into the shout out. So my first shout out is gonna go to Dolly Nay. Hey boo boo. Dolly Nay, she is super funny, y'all. Go check her out. Her stories are just hilarious. She got stories for days. So you guys go and check her out. Next shout out is gonna go to, I believe I already shouted her out before, but I'm gonna shout her out again one more time. Miss Essence TV, y'all. She is very big on astrology. So if you're into astrologies and just regular girl talk, go ahead and check her out and support her. My next one is to Chandler Tierra. A lot of her videos, she's actually getting ready to get married, so congratulations to you. So a lot of her videos is about her planning the wedding, her and her fiance planning the wedding and getting ready to get married. So you guys go and check her out. She might have some other stuff on there that you guys might like. But you guys go and check her out. My last shout out is actually gonna go to a man, and he is so funny, y'all. He is so funny, and his videos are actually pretty good, and his editing is on point. His name is Jamal Nolan, y'all. Go check him out. One of his videos, he made a video about Charlamagne the God, and Charlamagne the God actually ended up posting it on his channel. So you guys go and check it out if you want to learn more about celebrities and stuff like that. Go and check him out. He's also actually pretty funny. I met him on live. Y'all, before we get into this video, if you are like a great supporter of your subscribers, y'all, make sure when they go on live, enter the live. The live is a great way to network. Like, I've been on live with Deanna Monet. Shout out to Deanna Monet. Like, all week damn near. And I feel like I'm talking to my girls, you know. It's so fun. Like, we just be connecting. It seemed like we've been friends forever, if you ask me. And that's actually where I met Jamal. And it's just, like, her live has been phone dying, but I've been on her live, I've been on Alicia Sings live, and I've been on Diamonds, Pearls, and Curls, I want to say that's her name, live all week. And y'all, they lives be turned up, and I can't wait to go on live. I think I'm going to go on live next week. But it's a great way to network and really meet like some good supporters that will actually support you and watch your video. Anyways, so today I wanted to talk a little bit about like serious relationships, marriages, and stuff like that. If you are in a serious relationship or you're getting ready to get married, there is this book, y'all. It's this book called Before You Say I Do. Now, if you don't have time or the money to go and sit with a premarital counselor, or you don't have anybody to talk to or anything, get you this book, y'all. I love it. I haven't like started it yet, but get you and your man this book, or get you and your woman this book if you guys are thinking about marriage, because nowadays, you know, who's dating just to be dating? So while you're dating and y'all like get serious, get this book, y'all. It talks about everything, and it even mentions things that you wouldn't even think to ask. So basically, it's like an assignment book. And so basically, like, there's chapters. You would read the first chapter, and I believe the first chapter is about marriage. Yeah, the first chapter is about marriage. And so you would write down, like, it asks of it. So you read this, and then the first question is, define marriage. What is your purpose? Or what is the purpose of marriage? Do you believe that marriage is just a contract? Why or why not? How do you think your fiance or your man will answer these questions? And so you would write down your answers. And they have more. I believe this chapter is only like 3 or 4 pages. Yeah, it's only 1, 2, 3, 4. It's only 4 pages. And after you fill out your portion and he fills out his portion, you guys have a sit down like later on that week and talk about it. I feel like it's really important to really dig down deep before you decide to spend the rest of your life with this person. You know, personally, I'm a Christian, and I feel like if I'm going to marry somebody, I'm giving them my all, I'm giving them my life, you know. This is supposed to be my other half, my soulmate. We are one. There is no more I's, my's, and me's. It's no more that. It's we, us, everything. And it talks about marriage. It talks about what do you expect from a marriage, you know, because some people might have different views. Some people might, you know, be like, okay, yes, I'm married, but that don't mean I can't do what I want to do. You know, there's some of y'all out there. Or you might, y'all might be like, yes, we're married, but we don't share the same bank account or something like that. You know, it's just a lot of stuff. It covers roles. You guys will talk about roles and responsibilities and decision making. And which is very, very important to me. So if you're the type of woman that feels like her man should pay all the bills and you're just supposed to be a stay-at-home mom, if you're like if you're into like the old tales that a woman is supposed to be a stay-at-home mom and the husband is supposed to go and work and pay all the bills. I mean, some people are like that these days. I know a few people like that. And the man is okay with it. So it's whatever works for your relationship. Or the man might be like, no, you need to work too. Like, I'm not about to be the only one putting in all these bills. Like, you gonna want your hair and your nails done. You think I'm just supposed to pay for everything? Like, how is that supposed to happen? You know? So there's some of those. Okay, so I'm gonna read some of this stuff from the roles, responsibilities, and decision making chapter. So, like they have like a little comparison chart. So they have one for the wife and the husband, or the future wife and husband. And so basically you would circle numbers 1 through 5, 1 being strongly agree, 5 being strongly disagree. And then of course 3 is the middle ground, not sure. So like for example, A, the husband is the head of the home. So the wife would choose either 1 through 5, and then the husband would choose either 1 through 5, and you guys talk about it. And if he says 5 and the wife says, no, if he says strongly agree and then the wife is like disagree, then you guys talk it out. And you're just able to really just dig deep before you decide to devote your life to this man or to this woman. A lot of people fail to really ask questions before they get married. A lot of people assume, like, okay, we're about to get married, we'll have kids, but what about after kids? You know, Yeah, it's all fun in the beginning. You're in the puppy love stage or the puppy marriage stage or whatever they want to call it. But you're in the beginning of your marriage. And of course, you guys are all giddy and happy and just like, oh, my husband this. And he's like, my wife this. This my wife that, my wife this. And she's like, oh, my husband. Right? So what happens after all of that? Okay. What happens when shit gets tough? What happens if you guys... What happens if your wife is a shopaholic and you didn't even know? You know? What happens if your husband is just hella dirty? He don't pick up after himself, draws all on the floor, and that just irritates your soul. You know? What happens? Who is in charge of washing clothes? Is it the wife? Who's in charge? Or should the wife wash clothes and the husband fold? Should there be like a middle ground or some type of... role sharing responsibility or whatever? Or is the wife in control of the household and the man in control of the bills? I'm saying, so this is an awesome book. It also talks about finances, and you guys talk about that, and then it also talks about sex. All right, so some of the questions in the sex chapter is, what worries you about sex in your upcoming marriage? As a sexual partner, a husband should ... and you write your little answer. What will you do if you find yourself attracted to another person? Describe how you feel about your body. So if you are thinking about getting married and you don't want to pay to go see a counselor or anything, buy this book, sis, or bro, it's only $8. Get you one. I want to say this book is very, like, spiritual? Biblical? Something like that. But it has, like, little scriptures in here. In the first chapter, it says, where'd it go? Oh, it'll say, like, read Genesis 2:18-25. And you guys can read the Bible together. Like, I have not started this yet. But I bought this for me and my man, and it's called Before You Say I Do by H. Norman Wright and Wes Roberts. And no, this is not sponsored. I'm not paid to do any of this. I literally went on Amazon. This book was literally only like $8. It was only $8. So I love it. You can highlight anything, like whatever. That's really what I wanted to say. This is going to be a short little video. I'm not going to go into like extreme details. I'll put the link in the description box below. Let's just do a little eyeshadow cam real quick, because your girl hooked it up and I didn't do a tutorial on it. So sorry, this really isn't like a Freaky Friday kind of thing. Plus, I gotta go somewhere, so I can't make a super long video. This is just gonna be a short little video. Get straight to the topic, you know what I'm saying? Thank you guys so much for watching my video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You guys have an awesome day. Don't forget to enter the giveaway. And make sure you watch my video on getting scammed. Your girl got scammed, so go ahead and check that out. But I do have some free hair coming, y'all. They done already sent it. I didn't have to pay for nothing. So I do have some free hair. Okay? No shipping paid, nothing. So I'll be reviewing that very soon. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in a few more days, y'all. Bye.